So Flo, I just want to introduce you to the Royal Dream Team, our group here, and you may have to unmute yourself, but can you maybe, I know this might be a little hard because I know that there are several changes, but just kind of jumping right in, can you just give us like a brief overview, like maybe a little explanation as to why things are changing? Because I know that's probably the biggest question is like, why? Why are we updating? Do you want to maybe start there? And also, team, if you guys have questions on the Zoom, there is the Q&A button down here. On Facebook, you can put your questions in the comments, and when we get to that section, we will start answering all of your questions.
Yes. Well, first of all, thanks for having me here. I am so excited to meet with you. I love Terry, and so I'm really excited that I get this opportunity to meet her team. So yes, these changes, a lot of announcements came out last week, as you all know. I hope you've had some time to go into your virtual office and review some of the changes as well. We've done a few videos on our Young Living USA page, Facebook page to go over these changes. The main reason why we are doing these changes, it is required of us, and we just want to make sure that we have a company that is here for the long run, right? We want Young Living here for a very, very long time. And so we just made sure that we made these changes now so we didn't have to put a pause at any time for your income. We want to make sure that you have this income coming into your home monthly because we know that this is how a lot of people pay their mortgages, right? For food for the kids. And so we just don't want to have any hiccups along the road. I'm going to just pause there because I'm going to tell you to go to our virtual office under member resources. If you click commission plan, you'll see Mary's video that she goes over all the little details of why these changes are necessary. And I'm not going to try to pretend like I can do it better than Mary. So I'll say that, and I'll challenge you to go and watch Mary's video because one, she is just a beautiful speaker and did a fantastic job explaining the necessity of these changes. And then Beverly, do you want me to just go into the changes or pause there for a moment?
No, why don't you go ahead and go into the changes? As you guys have questions, pop them in. And so, Flo, I may just kind of like interrupt you as you're going through and just ask some clarifying questions. So, if anyone does have any questions, just go ahead and start throwing them in now. And we'll just work through them or save them till the end, whatever seems to work best. So, yeah.
Awesome. Okay, Beverly, could you actually make me a co-host and I will share my screen?
Yes. Okay, you should be good.
Okay, appreciate that.
Flo,
Okay.
is there a planned price increase for customers?
I have not heard anything. Obviously, if they're not upgrading to the wholesale price as a customer, then yes. But not that I've heard. Okay. So really briefly, I'll just touch, we're reclassifying, right? One of the main changes here is that we're reclassifying to brand partners and customers. Let's just bring that into our vocabulary and make it part of our lives because this is how it will be from now on. We will have brand partners and customers. As you see in your virtual office, you now will be able to see the icon for VP for brand partners and C for customers. I'm just going to go over a timeline of when these changes are happening because I know that was a little bit unclear at first as well. So here it is. In this PowerPoint, you actually can find it in the virtual office, as I mentioned, under member resources and compensation plan. If you want to individually go over these with your team or just review it yourself, Young Living has created this PowerPoint for you to utilize as a tool of training as well. So here's the timeline, April 1st. So excited. Tomorrow, Silverbound is coming back. What an amazing drive that you will have with your team. Hopefully, some huge blessing coming to you, maybe, or your team members. Silverbound, April 17th, we have our spring launch. April 21st, the new shopping platform will launch to all of our US members. May 1st, the ER bonus will retire, and we'll go over that in a minute. We'll implement the business support fee. retail earnings will retire, and then and we have a few more. So new fast start. Well, the new fast start will start, and some other things happening. My first will be the brand partner return policy. Reactivation and sponsor changes policy take effect on May 1st, and the business kit will launch as well. May 11th, all U.S. traffic will be redirected to that new shopping platform that is beautiful and exciting to shop in, so I'm so excited for everyone to be able to jump on board. June 1st, the new customer volume requirements will start, PSK bonus will retire, and the new starter bundles will launch as well. June 16th is our International Grand Convention, our virtual International Grand Convention, which again, so excited for. So I'm going to go over these tweaks, these announcements one by one. Feel free to ask questions. I'll do my best to keep an eye on the chat. But again, yeah, Beverly, just let me know if I miss something as I'm going.
Yes. Well, let me just ask you this question really quick. For newly enrolled members who want to do it as a business, but they haven't made a commission, like for ones that perhaps enrolled this month, will they be grandfathered in as business partners? Or if you haven't earned a commission, will you need to then purchase the business? I want to call it a business kit, but like the business. Right.
So it's if you have not earned a commissions or enrolled someone within the last 12 months. So if you've done one of these, you would be considered or have ranked up previously as a star or above.
Gotcha. So starting May the 1st going to May 1st of last year, if they've done one of those things, they'll be grandfathered in. If they haven't, then they will need to purchase the business pack.
Correct. Correct.
Okay, great. Okay, Vanessa, I hope that answers your question. If not, feel free to, you know, ask for clarifying questions.
Okay, let's go to retail earnings here. I saw a question pop up on the chat. Is that that question that you just asked for newly enrolled members who want to do this as a business but not have grandfather? Okay, perfect. Awesome. Okay, so retail earnings. Currently, members can earn 24% difference between a retail and wholesale price for their personally enrolled retail members. However, we are going away from retail earnings, and in the future, it will be retail earnings will retire on April 30th. So starting May 1st, this will not be applicable anymore. Once the brand partner and customer have migrated to a new shopping experience, brand partners will earn a fast start bonus on a newly enrolled customer for the first 3 months. Why is this change? This change gives a brand partner the ability to earn a fast start bonus for a full 3 months in place of a retail earning. Okay. The 15 ER bonus. I know it's some people even thought we didn't have this anymore anyway. So currently, if a member or a preferred customer enrolls as an ER with 100 PV order at any time, excluding the wholesale membership enrollment month, the enroller will earn an additional $15 bonus once an ER order processed successfully. In the future, starting May 1st, the ER bonus is going to retire. This will not be applicable at all for all markets. Why are we making this change? After careful analysis, we found that this program did not cause incremental business boost that we had anticipated when it was first created. As I mentioned, there was a lot of people who even thought this was gone years ago.
So, yeah, I actually had forgotten about it myself.
Yeah. So we just realized it wasn't the boost that we were hoping for, so we are putting it away. Fast Start bonus updates. Currently, you're able to earn 25% to the enroller for the first three months, plus a 10% on the second level enroller. In the future, starting May 1st, in the US only for right now, Fast Start will continue paying 25% to 10% when a brand partner enrolls a customer. Fast Start will continue paying out that customer even if that customer becomes a brand partner in the second or third commission period. Full unilevel commission will be paid out on newly enrolled brand partners instead of the fast start bonus. So you will be earning that 8% if they're on your first level, 5% if the second, so on. For those first 3 months, if they enroll as a brand partner, you wouldn't qualify for fast start, but you're still getting the full unilevel commission payout for that person. Okay. Why this change? This ensures that we are rewarding customer loyalty and giving new customers to join Young Living first and foremost, they love our products. Again, this is just a change that was necessary and requires the government regulations for us to make, but we're still making sure that we are rewarding you for bringing on customers and still getting a full unilevel payout for brand partners, for your leaders.
What I love the most about this is just that this is typically the way that the story goes for Young Living. Like, I don't know a brand partner who started without being just a product purchaser first. And so I think it's the natural flow of this will be good. I mean, that's kind of the way it happens anyway.
100%, totally. I love Eric Worre. So if you ever meet with me, you'll hear me talk about him a lot. But he talks about those first 90 days of when someone enrolls is critical for helping them create an emotional connection with our products. That's how we have long life product users, right? If I were around and asked each of you if you had at least one connection with our product, I know for a fact you would say yes. Whatever that product is for you. For me, I love Valor. I love Deep Relief. So those are like my go-to products, but I'm connected to these products. If I ever were to leave Young Living, I would just make sure that I enroll so I can keep getting those products every month in my home. So again.
Julie would like to know if you can just maximize your screen for the.
Oh, yes.
Yes. And then Vanessa is asking, do we not earn 24% commission on customers for the first 3 months? Sorry, Vanessa, I think I said that wrong. Do we not earn 24% commission on customers, or is it only for the first 3 months? I think that's what you're asking.
Yes. So it's only for the first 3 months is that bonus, the fast start bonus, it'll be the 25% on them. After the 3 months, you will earn an 8% unilevel commission as regular. This is just an added bonus that you will be getting the first 3 months when you enroll a customer.
Okay, and Sandy, I think on Facebook, I think that answers your question. So 24% on the first 3 months, then 8% or wherever it is that they land in that unilevel commission after that. Exactly. And Jennifer says, can a customer enroll under another customer? And if so, do they still get a commission?
Say that one more time.
Can a customer enroll another customer? I think we'll start there. We'll chunk it down. Can a customer actually enroll another customer?
Yes, they can. However, as a customer, you're not able to earn commissions. So I can enroll Beverly if I'm a customer. I will not be earning any commission on that, on my enrollment. However, though, if I enroll you as a customer right now, within that same commission period, I upgrade, I buy my brand partner bundle, I will now be considered a brand partner and will earn commission on you on that enrollment as long as it's within the same commission period.
Okay, sounds good. I'm just gonna go through some of these. Okay, go right on ahead.
Okay, all right, brand partner return policy. Brand partners can return unopened product within 12 months for a full refund, including shipping. Brand partners can return open product within 90 days for a full price product credit. Why this new addition? We wanted to create a low risk business opportunity that helps increase brand partners' confidence and offers a great flexibility if a brand partner needs to return a product. I know there was a lot of questions on this when WAY was first announced. One of the main questions was, what if I had a brand partner return a product 12 months down the line? Will that affect my rank? Will I miss out on a big chunk of my commission for that? The answer is no. You will not drop your rank. You will only have your commission retraction on the order. So what Young Living paid you out on that order itself, not your whole commission check for dropping rank because that will not be applicable. You will remain your rank and just get a commission retraction on the order that we paid out.
Yeah, that's awesome. And that was one of the biggest questions I think that I was asked. There's been a few questions about the brand partner bundle. The first question is just how much is it?
So that will be announced when it's released. I believe if I go back, I believe it's going to be released May 1st or May 12th. I'll double check that towards the end of this call for you. But once it's released, here, I'll just do that right now so then we can. Yes, May 1st. Once it's announced, the price will be released on that.
Okay, but it's not like $100 though, right? Like for some reason, I think I had seen it listed at like $15 or, you know, probably less than that. It's not super expensive.
Yeah, from what I can recall, it's a very small fee. I'm not completely sure if anything has changed since I last saw it. From the last time I did, though, it was a very small fee.
And a clarification on the refund, just a clarification question. So if you drop from silver to executive because a brand partner returns something, the paycheck will still be considered a silver paycheck, and that silver will still get any generational bonuses that they're earned, that they earned.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, let me see here. Brand partner. Do you know what is in the brand partner bundle yet?
I believe that we're waiting to announce that on May 1st.
Okay. And then let me just see if there's anything else. Senior Star. Oh, do you know, you may answer this a little bit later, but for the Silver Bound, you know, when they first did the Silver Bound policy, they kind of like restarted everyone. Is everybody going to get another reboot, or is it from this point on?
From this point on. So let's say that you hit this month, March, you hit executive, you will have the months of requirements, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe it's 4 months to get the silver bonus, or 6 months.
Gotcha. Oh, the kit is supposed to be $30, according to Jennifer, whom I'm sure read it somewhere. So a question on the customers, enrolling customers. Mm-hmm. So if you have a customer who enrolls a customer, does the top enroller get commission? So like if Christina enrolls me and I'm just a customer and I enroll my mom, does Christina earn the commission on my mom's order?
Yes, as long as Christina is a brand partner, yes.
Okay, great. Yep. I think that answers the questions. Oh, Paula's saying that if you click on the slideshow from the current slide, it will maximize your slide. Because we're seeing kind of like your slide, and then we're seeing like the next slide that you're putting up.
Oh, sorry, say that one more time then.
Yeah, can you blow up your slide? I think we're looking at like a presentation.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Let's see. Let me stop sharing for a quick second. Okay, what about now? Are you seeing my bigger screen?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Okay. So we are introducing now customer volume. I'm sure that this is one that you have lots of questions on. So current state is for stars, senior stars, and executives, in order to earn commissions, you will need 100 PV. The new, and starting, June 1st, this will be the new requirement, is U.S. brand partners up to executives, so again, stars, senior stars, and executives, will have a monthly requirement of 100 CV, customer volume, to earn commissions. This can be any combination of frontline sponsored customer or your own purchase PV. Brand partners of silver rank and above will continue to have the same requirements of 100 PV requirement. Is that clear?
Okay, let me see here. So Jennifer, on Facebook Live, I know you're asking a clarifying question. I don't understand your question. I'm so sorry. So you may need to, we will have a live question and answer at the end of this presentation. So if you have kind of a more complicated question, you may just want to pop on the Zoom so that you can ask and we can ask questions back. So I don't see any other questions.
Let me give some examples right here, just to give you an image. So let's say that I am a senior star, and this month I purchased 100 PV on my own. That will qualify me for commissions. That will count towards my CV. Let's say that Christina, sorry, you're right here. So Christina, I keep calling on you and Beverly, but you're right here. So Christina is one of my customers. Again, that's customer volume. She's one of my customers on my first level. She purchases 100 PV that month, and I can only afford to purchase a lemon oil this month, right? So she would qualify, her order would count towards my CV, her order and my order would count towards my CV requirement to earn commissions. And so I will get my commissions that month. Let's say that Christina and Beverly, I purchased absolutely nothing this month. This was a very hard month for me and my family, and I'm not able to purchase anything. Christina and Beverly purchased $50 each. Together, they make my one, and they're both customers, they make up my 100 customer volume requirement for me to still earn a commission that month. Is that pretty clear?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so why the change? This change highlights the role of customers play in helping create a strong team foundation. So again, this is where we want to go out and continue to find customers, people to love on the products, and create those connections, right? Those first 90 days, critical for making those connections with the products. And hopefully they will become a brand partner down the road because they want to continue to share this with their friends because they see the value in our products. So leg qualification, the current state is members are required to have 100 PV at the top of that leg. In the future, starting June 1st, a U.S. brand partner is required to have 100 CV or PV requirement applicable to their rank in order to qualify a brand partner and earn commission. For global members, the 100 PV requirement still remains, okay, because this is U.S. changes as of right now. Qualifying leg definition. To be a qualifying leg, on the top of the leg must be a qualifying brand partner with at least 100 CV or PV during the applicable commission period. If a brand partner at the top of that leg is not a qualifying brand partner during that applicable commission period, the qualifying legs under him or her will roll up for rank qualification purposes to the next qualifying brand partner. To determine which legs will be used for qualification, the OGV of each leg is considered from greatest OGV to least OGV. So I just escaped my mind. Compression will remain the same as is today. It will roll up to your next brand partner. Let's say that I have Beverly at the very top of my leg, but she's a customer. Underneath her, we have Christina, who is a brand partner. Beverly does not qualify my leg, right? But Christina will because she's a brand partner. Is that pretty clear? Okay.
Yes.
Sponsor changes update. So it's not really a change that here's just an update. So currently wholesale members are bound by sponsor change policy. In the future, now we will have customers and brand partners who will have 30 days from the enrollment to request a free sponsor change. If a customer becomes a brand partner after their first 30 days, they can request a sponsor and enroller change through the 3 upline approval process, or the 6 month of inactivity. So again, sponsor changes really remain the same. The only difference here is really that we now it's applicable for customers and brand partners, our new terms that are coming into play. Okay. Reactivation. This is how it will go moving forward. brand partners who do not engage in at least one of the following activities for a 12-month period will no longer be a brand partner and will reclassify it as a customer. They not enroll a Young Living individual, so a customer or brand partner, achieve the rank of star or higher in a compensation plan, earn a commission payment, purchase a sell toolkit from Young Living within those 12 months. To reactivate as a brand partner, you will need to order a business essential kit. So let's say that Christina, my brand partner, does not do anything for 12 months and none of these things are here. She will drop to be a customer. She can still upgrade again after those 12 months to be a brand partner. She will need to purchase that business essential kit again in order to reactivate. The business support fee, previously known as our maintenance fee, has gone up just a little bit. The fee will remain the same for those earning up to $99 on their monthly commission. It will increase slightly for higher amounts. So here's the chart showing the difference, or the new business support fee. Okay, why this change? The new monthly business support fee better reflects the cost of providing ongoing improvements to our commission system, business tools, and other areas of business that are directly support our brand partners.
A quick question from Joyce. When people reactivate, will they still get the wholesale discount?
Yes. Yep. Any other questions? We can turn to the question answer part of this.
Awesome. Okay, so there's our overview. Now, I know there are a lot of questions that are surrounding Essential Rewards and Subscribe to Save. So right now, for example, I'm at the 25% level where, on my Essential Rewards, I'm getting my 25% into my little bank, okay? So I know that Essential Rewards is now switching over into Subscribe to Save. So how does that work exactly? Is it just the items that I'm subscribing to monthly that I continue that on? And I'm just using myself as an example, but there's a lot of people who need clarification on what's going on with Essential Rewards.
Yes, of course. Yes. So Essential Rewards now Subscribe to Save. There's two parts to Subscribe to Save. There is that part where I want to unlock my 24% discount as a wholesale member. I can purchase a lavender and put it on my Subscribe to Save to come to my home every 2 months, every 3 months. I can switch out the product whenever that month is. But that's how I can unlock my 24% discount. But then there's the loyalty rewards part of Subscribe to Save, which is exactly what Essential Rewards is currently. You will need to purchase monthly at least 50 PV, and you will be able to earn your points back, same as applicable right now, and you will be able to earn the loyalty gifts as well.
Okay, awesome. And now, okay, so I do have a silver-bound question.
Yes.
Which is, if a customer, like a customer enrolls and they go an entire year without deciding to become a brand partner, does the countdown for Silverbound begin the second that they purchase their brand partner kit, or does it start from the second that they enroll as a customer?
It begins, I know someone had asked this before and we were getting clarification. I don't know if we did. I will write that down, and Beverly, I can text you and you can post it to the team. How about that?
Yeah, that sounds good. That sounds good. Okay, I'm just going to scroll up. I know I saw a few questions that we didn't get to. Is there any time frame for when the changes are going to reflect the NFR market?
Not as of right now.
Beverly, I have a quick question if you don't mind.
No, not at all. Go ahead.
Okay. This pertains to the last thing that you were showing us. And I don't think I missed it, but hopefully I'm not having you repeat. So if you're a brand partner, but that the little box you showed with like the four different things that you can do to keep yourself a brand partner within those 12 months, One, do you have to do all of those things, or is it just at least one of them to stay active? That's the first question.
At least one of them in 12 months in order to stay active.
Okay. And then the next part is, if you drop off, if you don't do any of those things in the 12 months and you lose that brand partner status, then you want to reactivate as a brand partner. So you buy that business essential kit. What happens to your downline? Do you lose? Because now, you know, if you don't stay a distributor, I guess, you know, you can lose your people. So is that what happens with it? I'm assuming everyone stays there, but that's a big difference, you know, if you're a customer versus, you know, a brand partner and you've got people under you that you're building.
Yes. Great question. Let me double check on that as well. I would imagine as you explain, if you drop from a brand partner to customer, your downline will remain there because you're still not inactive from Young Living. You're just inactive from being a brand partner, but I will double check that for you.
Okay, that's a good question. That's a good question. Before I used the example of Christina enrolling me enrolling my mom, but just being a customer. So Christina still earns the percentage. Okay. Mm-hmm. So with me being the enroller of my mom, does Christina still earn the 10% on my mom since I'm an enroller who enrolls? Or does she earn 25% since it skips me? How does that look like for the fast start bonus?
I will double check on that as well. I believe it is 10% because it is still your second level. But I will double check if compression would apply here as well.
Okay. Clarifying subscribe to save. Can subscribe to save be any PV amount? And can it change every month? 2 months or 3 months? Is there no minimum? Does the increment of time between the orders always stay the same?
Yes. So subscribe to save, there's no minimum PV. There's a minimum product, which is one. So you only have to have one product on subscribe to save. And you are able to change that as you see fit after you enroll in subscribe to save for the consistency of those orders coming into your home.
Okay. And so for the points, though, does it have, so like if I, again, this is, I know this is a difference between like the 24% wholesale versus my 25% point. Mm-hmm. So if all I have is a laundry soap that I'm getting once every 3 months, am I staying consistent in my ER ordering and I'm still gonna, you know, get that 25% off of my laundry soap, or how does that work?
Nope. So the new ER, which is loyalty rewards, remains the same. The requirements of 50 PV monthly in order to earn points.
Okay, great. Hopefully, Vanessa, that answered your question. And then when does shipping time frame change for essential reward orders?
Say that again. When does it change?
Mm-hmm. When does shipping time frame change for essential reward orders? We might need some more details on that, Diane.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
I don't know if anything in as far as shipping is concerned is changing, or at least I didn't hear it changing. Okay, I'm just going to scroll back up. If you have a question that hasn't been answered yet, you may need to repost it because I might have lost it in the stream here.
Beverly, I'm just going to ask the question because you didn't get to it, but... on the return policy, it's mm-hmm. brand partner only that can return, 12 months unopened, 90 days opened. However, mm-hmm. because we're kind of changing the definition of those who we enroll as customers, all of them are customers, does the brand partner take responsibility for returning their product for them if they're dissatisfied?
So if a customer purchased a product that they want to return, they would be returning from their own account. The brand partner does not have to return it for them. The customer themselves can return it, and the same return policy applies, the return policy that is as of today applies to customers. Nothing's changing for them for return policy.
Okay, so a customer only has 30 days to return opened or unopened product, and they have to pay shipping on that return. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, but the brand partner gets free shipping to return those products.
Correct. And as long as it, or excuse me, I don't think it's, is it free shipping? I think it's, they can return it. They have to pay the shipping. They get a full refund to what we paid for shipping that order out to them.
Oh, but you still have to pay shipping to ship it back if you want to return it.
I believe so.
All right. I read that differently. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Do enrollers earn CV or commissions on BP bundles? So are we earning commission on those business bundles?
I do not know on that. Great question, you guys.
Are customers paying full retail? JR would like to know.
Not if they upgrade to the 24% discount, because again, I can be a customer and get my wholesale discount by either purchasing 100 PV in my customized bundle when I enroll as a customer, or by putting one item on subscribe to save. And I can choose the frequency of that subscribe to save order, and I will unlock my 24% discount.
Yes, and on those, just to clarify, the initial order for a customer to receive that 1 year of 24% discount, those are gonna be starter bundles, which we will be seeing soon, but they are also fully customizable as well. Is that right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Great. Okay, JR, thank you for your question. Awesome. This is fantastic. I'm glad I'm feeling like now that I've now seen this three times, I feel like I'm seeing it. Okay, Valerie says, so people who are currently enrolled in Essential Rewards and not just to purchase wholesale products don't really experience any change, right?
Yep. Nope. As long as they're on Essential Rewards getting it monthly, they will just roll over to loyalty program and be able to still earn the points, get the loyalty gifts when they hit those months of consistent orders.
The question from Kathy is, what if there is a defective item, like a diffuser? For defective items, do you have a year to return them?
Yep. That's still the same. The only change is that new brand partner return policy. Other than that, our return policy is the same for everything else that we have right now.
Okay. So there is a question that I'm not sure if you would know the answer. We might just have to think about it a little bit. But the question is there are some leaders that have like flip kits, like they purchased kits from 2019 and they've been using those to kind of go back and forth. So what should they do with the flip kits that they have, those premium starter kits that they've got?
Yes, great question. I would make sure that we get them sold ASAP. I mean, we still have a little bit, right? And still until starter bundles come into play. So we do have some time to play with. Someone just asked too if our premium starter kit going away completely. I'm not sure because those starter bundles, maybe some of them will include what we already have in those premium starter kits. What I would say though is if you do have a flip kit right now, that's something that you can promote and incentivize to your team to your prospects is I have this on hand. I can give this to you right now. Young Living is doing some updates on their starter bundle. This is a great opportunity if you've ever wanted this specific premium starter kit to get it right now in your hands.
Okay. Yeah, that's a really good point. I'm excited about that too. Just
a caveat on that, if I might. So you're saying get rid of them as soon as we can, because I have three. When I get rid of it, I reorder. I mean, I have to place that order because that's what they ordered. I mean, can you order something else? I mean.
Yeah, and that's why I'm mentioning I would use it before starter bundles come into play, because you still do have some time to place the order as is. let me double check the date on starter bundles when they're coming into play.
Yeah, I understand what Christina's saying, because what she's saying is that normally you pick up that starter bundle, you hand it to the customer, and you ship their starter bundle to you. So, yeah, that's interesting. And then Jennifer, I know, okay, I see your question and I will ask it in just a minute. I'm just waiting for Flo to finish up with this one, just in case you thought I forgot about you.
Oh, it's June 1st that starter bundles are coming in.
Okay, June 1st.
Mm-hmm.
Christina, do you have anything else to ask about that?
Well, I guess I ended that question with, so do I order something else to have shipped to me that comes to the same price as the starter bundle so that I don't have the starter bundle? I mean, I know, Beverly, you understand what I'm saying.
Yeah,
I understand what you're saying. And that's probably what I would do. I mean, I would just, I don't know. I know it's tough because it's like, it's not one for one. So what do you do with what you currently have? I get it. Unless you're just going to sell it at retail.
Yeah, and maybe this, and again, this is not Young Living sponsored, right? This response, this is Flo answering this. And maybe it can be that you wait until June 1st when we do have those customizable kits. You give that new person their premium starter kit as is. Let's say you have an Aria premium starter kit, and then you customize a new starter bundle that is popular of requests. People come to you that you can also have on hand with when June 1st comes to play to flip that if you want. But yeah, flip kits are tricky because of that.
Yeah, true. Is there anything else about that, Christina, before I ask another question?
No, I'm good, thanks.
Okay, so Jennifer is asking, once a customer decides to become a brand partner, is there a 30-day timeline to move that brand partner within the business, or will they have to do a 3-upline approval?
They will have to do a 3-upline approval or inactive for 6 months. I'm just pulling it up again just to make sure I'm giving you correct information. Yes. So if a customer becomes a brand partner after their first 30 days, they can request a sponsor enroller change through the 3-upline approval form or a 6 months of inactivity.
Okay, great. Subscribe to save PB amount. Okay, I think I'm just going to come through here. Okay. Katrina is saying she's got 9 flip kits. I understand what you're saying. 24% discount. Okay, so Cassie is saying, while customers who purchased a starter bundle and get, so let, I'm gonna ask this question first and then it will lead to this one over here. So what is the difference between a starter bundle and the business bundle?
So the business bundle will be for people who want to upgrade to be a brand partner. So again, I can enroll as a customer and purchase my 100 PB order. And I will also need to purchase the business kit in order to be a brand partner. I can also, let's say that instead of doing 100 PB, that's a lot of money for me. I can't do that right now. Plus a brand partner kit, I will just need to put one product in subscribe to save to become a customer and purchase my brand partner bundle in order to become a brand partner.
Yes. Yeah, so the starter bundles can be purchased and then you just get your 24% off and just kind of keep ordering, you know, for the next 12 months, you got to place that order, you know, mm-hmm. Just to clarify. And then the business, I mean, you could be a customer for 5 years and then decide to go ahead and just add on a business bundle to become a brand partner. So this Cassie is asking, while customers who purchase a starter bundle and get the 24% discount a year, so will they need to spend 100 PV every year or just put one item on subscribe to save to keep the 24% discount moving forward?
Yes, yep, exactly what she mentioned in that second option. If I purchase a 100 PV order in my starter bundle and then do not place again anything until my 11th month, I just need to have one item in Subscribe to Save in order to keep my discount.
Okay. I have another question, Beverly.
Yes, go right ahead.
Okay, so say I have a customer that orders once every 3 months and she's never wanted to be on ER. So Save to Subscribe is probably not going to be appealing to her. From the time that these changes take place, do her prices go up to retail immediately?
If she's right now a wholesale member?
Yeah, but she's not a business builder. She buys maybe every 3, 4, 5 months, but she makes sure she gets her 50 PV every year and she's not interested in Save to Subscribe.
Yeah, so she will be reclassified right now as a customer with the discount that she has. And then she will then after the year need to place her at least one item in Subscribe to Save, or I believe she'll be able to purchase 100 as well to remain with that discount.
Okay, so that criteria has really changed, because it used to be $50 to, you know, keep your account active, but now it's going to be 100. And if she chooses not to do Subscribe to Save, then that's, she just.
Yeah, I'm just opening my FAQs really quick, because I do believe that was clarified there. And I just want to make sure that I gave you correct information, and I apologize. My dog is barking.
No, that's fine. And that's why I'm kind of reiterating some of this stuff, because it's not real clear to me, and I apologize.
No, you're good. Let's see.
No, these are good questions, because you know that they're going to be coming up for everybody as we're all experiencing the different changes.
Okay, can I throw something out there to see if I'm actually understanding what Christina is saying correctly while you're looking for the...
Yes, you bet.
Okay, so since your person is already in and she's going to be grandfathered in, she'll already be getting the discount on the products. And it sounds like she's definitely ordering more than once a year. So if she orders twice a year, three times a year, she will continue to keep getting that 24% discount as a customer. Is that correct?
Correct.
Does that order, do those two or three orders a year have to be in the Subscribe to Save, or can it just be an order that she places?
Regular orders.
Regular
orders. I will double check. And Christina, I'll double check on that requirement as well to if it is 100 or 50 PV, because I'm looking through the FAQs and it's not on there. So I am sure that's going to be a frequently asked question. So I will make sure that we get, you know, we talk to our communications team and possibly add that onto the FAQs.
Thank you.
Yep.
Flo, there is a question here about this approval form for moving. So if somebody, let me see here, for the three applying approval form, will it have to be signed by three brand partners, even if a customer is ordering the 100 PV themselves every month? Or will that approval form also need to be signed by customers?
I would believe it would be brand partner. Usually as it is right now, it will go, I believe it goes to your three executive and above uplines as it is right now. So I'm imagining it will remain as we will go to a brand partner for the three upline approval form.
My understanding is that it goes to the three immediately above them. Their sponsor. It has nothing to do with rank.
Yeah. I would agree.
Let me ask. I have my contact right here from commissions. Let me ask.
So, I mean, I would imagine that it would need to be signed, because if a customer can sign up a customer, you know, if I signed up a customer, I think I wouldn't be too happy if my three business brand partners on top of me moved them.
Yes, I just asked him really quick. It looks like he just saw my message, so I'll get an answer for that pretty quickly.
Okay.
Any other questions while we get that one answered?
What about orphan brand partners? Will they be assigned a sponsor? And if so, how will the sponsor be chosen?
As is right now, executive and above. And that's the rule for our current placement program. They will find the nearest executive and above leader close to them.
Jenny asks, I hit executive but dropped to senior star. Will I qualify to run for the Silverbound bonuses when they kick in again?
She was executive. She dropped to senior star. Not unfortunately, unless, when did you hit executive?
How long ago, Jenny, if you want to pop that in on Facebook Live? Sorry, I know this recording runs a little bit behind, so it might take her a minute to see it.
Okay, and I have a really silly question. And I guess maybe as a business builder, it seems silly to me, but maybe it wouldn't to somebody who's a customer. But what would be the point, if you're a customer, to sign up a customer, but not then yourself choose to be a brand partner? Because you're going to lose out on any bonuses or money that you would earn for signing your person up.
Totally. Yeah. And that's on the only reason we are doing that is because legal requirements of making sure that no one's earning a check without wanting to earn a check for like tax reasons or whatever it is that they don't want to be, you know, having an extra income. We're giving them that option to not earn a check if they do not want it. But again, having that option to earn a check if they do want it.
Okay.
It looks like Jenny had dropped to senior star a few months ago.
Okay, so no, she would not be applicable for the silver bonus, because that would be the next one she would qualify for. However, once you do hit silver, Jenny, you will be in the running for bridge to gold that you can achieve within 6 months after hitting silver.
So Joyce says that you saw something saying that you have to opt in to the orphan placement program. And if you do need to opt in, where would you do that at? I have not heard of members needing to opt in, but I've heard that, you know, you do see it when a brand new member is signing up. There's two options. One is they put in a sponsor number and an enroller number, or they have to choose the second one where they are acknowledging that they will be basically placed in a random organization. But I haven't seen that, Joyce, on the other side. I have received orphans and I've never opted into a program anywhere.
Exactly. That's what I have always seen. I have not seen anything different into where to opt out into the orphanage program. Or the placement program, sorry, placement.
So Vanessa asks, I've been executive for many months now. Is it possible for me to get the Silverbound bonus once it starts again? Does my time start over? And I think what I'm understanding is there will not be a reboot. So the first time Silverbound came out, you kind of got this little reboot. There will not be a reboot the second time it comes out, correct?
Correct, exactly.
Okay, you guys, it is 1 o'clock. Is there any last minute questions that anyone needs to ask before we go? Okay, it doesn't look like it. Okay, well, Flo, thank you so much for coming on. If I get a bunch more questions, I may just send you an email, or maybe we will have you on again. But thank you so much for joining us. And we definitely appreciate you taking the time, because I know changes are always kind of hard to wrap your head around. So
Yes. Thank you all, honestly. And Bev, thanks for getting this together. I will send you an email with the questions that I got today, and feel free again to send me any other questions my way.
Okay, and Jenny, just a clarification on yours. The upline approval form, I think we're not sure. So she's going to. Christina?
Beverly? Where would we find the video that of Mary's video that she mentioned that we might be able to watch a couple of times?
It is in the virtual office under member resources, and then you have to click on compensation plan. It is the very first video there. Actually, on that same page, you will find the PowerPoint that I went over today, the FAQs, and then some other videos, training on the Fast Start bonus and CV that you can also share with your team, to explain these new changes.
Awesome. So virtual office, member resource, and then compensation plan.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. And for those who are asking where this recording will be shared, I will actually put a link into Facebook. It won't be a Facebook link, just in case the person that you want to share it with doesn't happen to be on Facebook, but I will download it. I'll give us all a link so that you can share it with people who are not able to be here live. So thank you guys so much for sharing some of your Wednesday with us. Thank you, Flo, for joining us, and we will see you all next week. Next week, we are doing, it has a really cool title, and I'm not going to remember it, but we're actually going to be joined by a Crossline member who is absolutely amazing, Donna Caldwell, and we're doing essential oils for people with very busy lives, but imagine that having a much cooler title. So hopefully we'll see you guys next Wednesday. Have a great week, everybody.